Clinton last night. You know, many people said it was sort of this love story, the tale of their lives. But there's a Washington Post op-ed that came out that said, whenever the Clintons put their marriage at the center of the political cases they make for each other, the relationship becomes more vulnerable to criticism. How do you make their marriage the center focus when you can't not think about the darker times?
You know, I think last night was just an extraordinary speech. He has been her husband for decades. They have shared their lives together, and people really wanted to hear from him who Hillary is, the Hillary he met back in 1971. And so he spoke about that very movingly last night and talked about the fights of her life, who she was as a young woman, the choices that she made. And so we thought it was a really moving, wonderful speech and tribute to her.
Without a doubt, but if we're talking about authenticity and trustworthiness, this is Bill Clinton we're talking about. He wants to talk summer of 1971, while other people could say, how about the Monica Lewinsky summer? Why put yourself in this position? There were other people who spoke last night who could speak with passion about the work they've done. Why have Bill do this? It really raises a question.
Well, I just thought he wanted to give a very personal tribute to his wife and talk about the Hillary he knows. And we thought it was just incredibly moving. And I have to say, being there last night in the arena, people were really touched and moved by what he had to say. And, you know, everybody wants to know about who she was as a young woman. And he really is the speaker who could give people a real sense of her.
Why is it, though, that the focus is, let's humanize her? We've known Hillary Clinton for decades. She's done extraordinary things. Why do we suddenly need to know what a warm wife and mother she is? Why does she need to be warm? We're at a time of terror. Yesterday, we had a priest murdered in Normandy. Why don't we talk about that, her expertise as Secretary of State? Why do I care that she loaded up Chelsea and got her ready for college?
Well, Stephanie, you actually just gave a phenomenal preview of tonight. Tonight, we're going to be talking about leadership, and we have two speakers who know Hillary and served with her in the Situation Room and are going to talk about what it takes to be Commander-in-Chief, and that's President Obama and Vice President Biden. So we've got an incredible lineup tonight. The focus of tonight is leadership and what it takes. And we're going to have people who know her, can vouch for her steadiness, her leadership capabilities, her knowledge. And so you're going to have an incredible lineup tonight.
Why do you feel that we don't know the real Hillary, though? Why is there this shift to get to know who she is as a woman? She's got a 100% name recognition out there. Everybody knows who Hillary is.
You know, I have to say, Stephanie, I travel with her a lot, and I talk to people who come to her events, and it's really interesting to me how many Americans know the jobs that she's had. They know her as Secretary of State. They know her as First Lady. But especially young Americans, they don't know a lot about her life before that. They don't know what got her into public service, what her values were as a young woman, the choices that she made. And so last night, we really wanted to talk about the fights of her life to give people a real sense of who she is and what she's cared about even before people knew her on the public stage.
Then what do you attribute her high unfavorability rating to?
You know, I think President Clinton said last night she has been at the forefront of change her entire life. This has been a woman fighting for universal health care, for equal pay for women.
Then why don't people like her?
When you're at the forefront of things, a lot of people criticize you for it, and she's taken that on for decades. But she's done it because she's a change maker, that she really cares about these issues, and she stays in the fight. She never gives up. And I think we heard Michelle Obama talk about that, about Hillary on Monday, which was really meaningful to her, and part of the reason that she believes that she's the best choice to be the next president of the United States.
Well, I look forward to tonight. Thanks for joining us, Mr. Chockey of the Clinton campaign. President Obama.